A good spawn where you can get a quick buck, where the experience isn't so bad either and close by town. Welcome to the mage version of Where Are Hyenas. A nice balance between experience and profit, and yet very few mages go to this place. Is the risk ratio too high? Well, let's find out. Before we kick off, I want to let you know I've done a night version of this place already, and you can find that video in the description. Let's analyze the monsters first. We have to know their main source of damage and also their weakness in order to hunt here. The regular Were Hyena does one death attack, the death beam that's aerial and can be dodged. Other than that, we have the sudden death that can't be dodged, so you will always have that damage if they cast it. It's misleading because of its name, but it's actually a physical type of damage. And as last attack we have Earth Berserk, a regular Exori attack and can be dodged if not standing next to one of them. Next we have the Shaman, the stronger version and the more annoying ones in terms of survivability. These creatures do three sorts of death damage. Death Beam that can be dodged, Sudden Death is a direct hit on you, and again the Poison Berserk. As last we have the Poison Ball, they always cast that ability on you, so there's no way to dodge that attack. If we sum that up, death damage is the main source here, followed by Earth. Apart from the physical damage of course. On screen you can see my personal damage types after 1 hour hunt. So as for general equipment for both Druid and Sorcerer, I'd say Dwarven Legs, Dreamwalker Boots and Shoulder Plate. Sorcerers are better equipped against death damage with Galea Mortis and Robe of the Underworld, while Druids can use Yalahar Mask or Gil-Gugul and Bare Skin with the option of Death or Life Imbuement. Now what about their weakness? Like I said on my other video as well, both Were Hyena and the Shamans are 25% extra weak to Holy and 20% to Ice. So Avalanche Runes will be amazing. On lower levels Druid has more advantage compared to Sorcerers, simply because of the strong Ice Wave. Doing that attack is literally destructive in this place. But on the other hand, Sorcerer got a greater survivability with the Death Protection equipment. On the flip side of the coin, they are strong against Druid's Earth Wave and Sorcerer's Fire Wave. I wouldn't really advise using these waves here. On this particular hunt I didn't use any preys, but if I were to pick one for this hunt, I'd go with Loot or Damage Prey. But everything works here, since they are all beneficial in their own way. A low level will probably have more benefit on a defense prey rather than having an experience prey, for example. If you have the Holy Charm unlocked, definitely put that one on Shamans and Freeze on regular Were Hyenas. But if you lack the Holy Charm, you can enable Freeze on Shamans and Zap, Wound or Curse on Were Hyena. Now about the experience and profit part. On this hunt I've had a stable 4kk experience per hour as a level 400, sometimes it peaked at 4.3kk but also had some drops on particular places. If I were to put a boost and prey on the regular Were Hyena, it would definitely rise to 6.5kk per hour. So the experience isn't bad at all, especially because of the low difficulty rate. As for profits, I've had around 450k profits per hour. I had a huge chunk of loot skipped and was looting mainly valuables and rods or wands. The visits to depot would have been crazy otherwise, since a mage doesn't have that much capacity. The minimum supplies you should be carrying to hunt here is at least 200 ultimate mana potions with 800 avalanche runes for at least a 30-minute hunt. It all depends a bit on your capacity and the amount of items you are looting, so drop your empty flasks regularly. To complete this place you would need max 3 hours, or 1 stamina hunt. I personally killed 800 Were Hyenas per hour, and close to 500 Shamans. It all depends on how fast you kill the creatures, but take your time as a level 200-ish because they deal a considerably amount of damage. If you feel you have too few space to run around, there are quite a few spots where only 3 creatures can attack you. You always have the option to hunt with your familiar and let it box for you. As for hunting route, I stayed on -2 the whole time, mainly the southern part. It's more than enough to maintain full respawn and experience per hour. But you can also take the full cave if you feel you are overkilling the spawn. During this hunt I had 1 critical imbuement along with 2 times void and 1 magic level imbuement. So as a final conclusion I'd say Were Hyena Cave is a great spot to hunt it for a mage. Whenever you don't have a team at that particular moment, or you're just a solo player, this cave is great to have a quick buck while getting good experience. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful in any way. If you did, please give it a like and make sure to subscribe to the channel. That's the best way to keep up to date with my content and great support to the channel growth. I'll see you in the next video. Stay safe.